Alamance County is pleased to present the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
Good evening to everyone. Appreciate your attendance and hope you find the meeting informative. Before we start with our agenda, I'd like to ask Commissioner Vaughn to give our invocation.
I took the pleasure of inviting Pastor Jonathan Harrison from Holly Hill Baptist Church here to give the invocation and to keep one of our commissioners in check.
Let's pray together. Father, we just thank you for this awesome day that you have provided us. God, the gift of life each and every day that you give us is a wonderful blessing. And I pray, God, today we've used it to your good and your pleasure. Lord, we thank you for the opportunity to meet together tonight. We thank you for the commissioners. We pray, God, that your blessing would be upon this time, that you would give them wisdom. And God, that you would salt all of our words with compassion and but also honesty. God, as we deal with the things that are before us. But God, we want to do these things that which is right. And I pray, God, that you just give us wisdom to be able to discern that. God, we thank you that we can not only love you, but love our neighbors. And God, tonight certainly we'd want to remember our neighbors in Iowa. And God, the tragedy and the flooding and the really disaster that's going on there. We pray, God, that you would be with the leaders there, that you'd be with the emergency responders and others, God, and that you would give them wisdom and great compassion as they minister to many needs there. Be with the people of Iowa, that area, and God, in their devastation. And the Lord, that you would continue to show yourself faithful, that in the midst of what would look like a disaster, God, you're at work and you're going to show your love and your compassion through people. Lord, we thank you tonight that we have a wonderful county, Alamance County, that you've given us these days to live in. We pray, God, that we would not only be good stewards of the wonderful resources here, but God, that we would just appreciate the blessing of living in a wonderful country like the United States and a place like North Carolina and Alamance County. God, that we would give every bit of it our best. Thank you most of all that we can meet here tonight in this freedom. And God, that we would just be honest before you that, Lord, we need a lot of healing in our country and the political process and other things. We just need a great revival. And Lord, we just pray that you would bring us together. In the powerful name of Jesus, I pray.
Amen. Let me say something before we get started. Jonathan is my minister, and he's getting ready to leave for China the 22nd of June. He's going to be taking a bunch of young people over there for 10 days or 12 days. How long is it, Jonathan?
10 days.
We're proud of him at Holly Hill Baptist.
Pastor Harrison, thank you for taking your time out of your busy schedule to be here tonight. We thank you.
Jonathan also was, he was an EMS supervisor. In which county, Jonathan?
Carter County, Tennessee.
Okay, Tennessee. So he's familiar with how county governments and city governments work.
I had 24 county commissioners. So,
yeah. Oh, my. Oh, my.
Say about 10 million people in your county.
One time.
50,000, unfortunately. Tennessee's a little different.
It is.
Okay. I understand from our HR director that no one has signed up for public comment, so we'll get right into the order of business. First being a public hearing on the North Carolina Department of Transportation 2008-2009 Secondary Road Improvement Program. Mike Mills, the division engineer. Mike? Or Mr. Gaya?
I'm all pretty empty.
Yes, sir. We welcome you here, sir.
Thank you very much. You. Mr. Chairman, members of the board, my name is Doug Galyon, and I represent Alamance County on the North Carolina Board of Transportation. We're here this evening to present the 2008-2009 Secondary Roads Construction Program for Alamance County. As you will recall, we came to you last year to present our 2006-2007 program and also 2007 and 2008. I am glad to tell you that these programs, all of those programs, are well underway by our maintenance forces and it is expected that these two programs will be completed by the fall of this year. And to present the 2008-2009 program, I would like to introduce our division engineer, Mike Mills, who will introduce his staff and present our program to you. We'll be glad to answer any questions after the presentation.
Thank you, Mr. Gary.
Thank you, Doug. Mr. Chairman, fellow commissioners, I do have with me tonight our county maintenance engineer, Danette Fogelman. Danette, if you'll stand up. Chuck Edwards, our district engineer, and Brad Wall, our division maintenance engineer. Brad is in the Greensboro office with me. Danette and Chuck are local, so please give them a lot of complaints. Do you have the program?
We have a good staff.
I appreciate that, Larry. Thanks. You have your program in front of you for 2008-2009. I'll go ahead and get started. Our total anticipated allocation is $1,561,613. And I will just go down the list of our proposed program. We, as Doug was saying, we came to you last year with two programs, and in the 07-08 program, we went down through priority number 14. And you notice that on this one, we have a right-of-way 9. That was a road that was on the right-of-way hold list. It was on the program years and years ago. It's now been a change of heart. The property owner said they would not sign the right-of-way, so we put it back on the list. We're starting with number 19. The gap between 14 and 19 is we have some projects to close out during the year, and when we close them out, the money came available. So we went down the list, and we just went down and have now programmed number 16, which is Tom Anderson Road, number 17, Charlie Lewis Road, 18 is the Brown Road, and we also funded a subdivision road, Carlton Road, and those roads will be in the 07-08 program. So now I'll get started with the 08-09 program, and again, the right-of-way whole list is Ober Road. Priority number 19 is Lewis Road. Number 20 is R.P. Cox Road. Number 21 is Wyatt Road. Number 22 is Smoky Hollow Road. Number 23 is Bill Aldridge Road. Number 24 is Hassel Corbett Road. Number 25 is Dixon Lane. Number 26 is Harvey Chandler Road. Number 27 is Belmont Lane. Number 28 is Ed Patterson Road. Number 29 is Clark Lane. Number 30 is Pascal Road. Number 31 is Thompson Mill Road. And number 32 is the partial funding of Carl Madron Road. And that's 5.3 miles of rural roads. If you turn your page, on the second page, the very top, that one is if we do have some of these roads to fall out, can't get the right of way or wherever the case may be, then we propose to go and complete the funding of the Carl Madron Road. Except to the last page, and you'll see on number 4, the road additions is Callaway Drive down the southern part of the county. We're proposing to spend $60,000 to complete that section of that subdivision. We'll have all of Callaway Drive on the state system once we get this done. It's a platted right-of-way, so right-of-way won't be a problem. We'll go in, make some unpaved road improvements, maybe widen the ditches a little bit, put down some more stone. Once we do that, then that section of Callaway Drive will be on the state maintenance. That is our program. We, again, as usual, we're proposing to have about $26,000 left in reserve for overruns, road additions, paving volunteer fire department drives, things like that. Mr. Chairman, that is our program. Be glad to answer any questions commissioners may have or from the public this time.
Okay. Well, we are in a public hearing. Is there anyone in the audience that would like to speak on this? Does everyone understand which roads are on the improvement list for this, Steve?
Mr. Mills, I'd like to ask a question. We've got a fire department pavement reimbursement at Eli Whitney. It's 30-some thousand, and I didn't hear that come out. Will that be included in this?
It always is. I mean, it's usually, when did you turn it in? Mr. Edward Fund, I turn it in.
We've been working with you for a while. There is a line item, it's not specific to any particular fire department, but there's a line item in there that we use a portion of this money to help fund construction of fire department driveways as they come up, and Eli Whitney would be one that will definitely direct some funding to you.
Is this a new driveway?
Yes.
That's under public access fund, which is not part of secondary road. What you normally do is you would send your request into Chuck, he would do an estimate, and then we submit it for reimbursement out of Raleigh office. The problem is public access funds are distributed statewide, so you may not get it within the next month. I see them last at least 6 months before the money starts coming back, but you will get reimbursed for, because in front of the bay, you'll get reimbursed for that.
Okay, that's all we want to know.
We don't do part of it, but in front of the bay for the fire trucks, we do reimburse for that.
Right.
Mr. Mills, I live on Callaway Drive, and I'm the one that got the petition up and gave it to Chuck. We'd like to know when maybe this project will get started.
A big part of it is actually getting the Board of Commissioners approval tonight, and from there it will then go to our State Board of Transportation for approval. Once we get those approvals, we can actually go ahead and schedule and start that project.
You have a ballpark?
Well, once that the resolution comes from the county, then we can put it on our board agenda, the Board of Transportation, as Doug is the chairman. It may not make the July board, because it's already in the middle of June, so it may not make the July board. It may make the, it'll probably make the August board. Now, once the board approves it, it's the state system road. So we can go in the next day and start machining or putting down stone, whatever.
I've been eating dust down there for 21 years. I mean, 2 or 3 more months, I ain't going to
hurt. This is not going to pave the road. It's not paved.
Well, now, let me ask you another question. I got a call from Carrie Allred the other day, and he said something about the road will be paved maybe by next year.
It's possible. We're gonna re-rate all the unpaved roads this coming winter.
Yeah.
And so we'll rate that. And to be honest, I think Crofton Road is the last subdivision road we got. So Callaway Drive would be my number one on subdivision roads. But then we'll sit down and probably, you know, be next year for it to be on the
floor. We have several families down with school kids. My next door neighbor has to get up in the morning and take her daughter about a mile up the road to catch a bus, and then turn around an hour later and take it. And those buses have to turn around about halfway down Callaway off of Jeremiah and double back.
Well, I can honestly say it probably won't make the July board meeting with the DOT.
Well, it may, because we're meeting a week later.
Well, that's true,
than
too.
We normally do. So we'll push it as hard as we can to get it approved in July board meeting.
I've got COPD. He's got heart problems, and all that dust down there don't help a thing. But like I said, you know, I've been doing it for 20-some years. I'm not going to be bent out of shape if it don't get done by next week.
Well, what we can do is normally when a road is after the state system, Chuck writes the property owner.
Yeah.
He can easily, I guess, write the school system, make sure they all know it's on the state system. Once the board approves it, whether it's July 9th or August 2nd, wherever it is, it becomes a state system road, which means school buses go down it, the mail delivery go down it, everything else.
That's something else we were asking. One of my neighbors said something about they take it over, could we put our mailboxes up front of the house? I got to go half mile and get my mail now.
Yeah.
Well, it'll be a state system road. I can't ask for the mail there, so.
We'll argue with both of them.
Yeah, I'll have to ask them.
All right, thank you, sir.
It has to be back.
So. Yeah.
The mailbox has got a specified, was it 3 feet?
Yeah.
Or something less, like that. So be sure that it's, it's back there.
All right,
thanks, sir.
Yes, sir.
I have a question on the same thing. All right, you're saying they're going to take it over as just a gravel road to start.
Yes, yes.
Okay, how will they determine when it becomes a paved road?
What we'll do,
the amount of traffic.
No, well, this coming year, we will go through and rate all the unpaved roads again. We look at the houses, we look at traffic, we look at the school bus route, we look at some of the thoroughfare system, and you get these points. And there's two different categories. One's a rural road, one's a subdivision road. Now, Callaway Drive is a subdivision road. So you got two paving priorities. Callaway, with only being one subdivision road this time, and we've got Clarkin Road on the list, so no other subdivision comes in from now and we rate Callaway Drive number one is subdivision road. So chances of being paid pretty good.
The reason we re-rate every 4 years, if you did it every year, new subdivisions would come on and there would be roads that's down there for 20 years and never get paid because they keep moving up, so we freeze it for a 4 year period and give those people the opportunity to have their road paid.
I've got several copies of our rating sheet, Mr. Chairman. If you mean I can give them to the county commissioners and also people in Olive, you can do that.
Okay. Any other comments from the public? Does any commissioners have any comments? Mike, on the Burnett Chapel Road, and that, I don't know if that's been taken care of or not. You know if it's, can you look at that?
Yes, sir. You know what the problem was?
No, I mean, it's on down the list, but it's...
Oh, okay.
They called me about every year. I hadn't heard from them, so I think maybe the road got taken care of.
Yeah, we do that. I'll let you know, Larry.
Okay.
Mr. Chairman, in order to get the ball rolling, we would appreciate a resolution from the board approving our proposed paving program.
So moved that we approve that.
Second.
Any questions? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carries.
Thank you,
we'll
sir.
We'll forward that resolution right on to you.
Very good. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. Subdivision sheet, rural road sheet. But the same sheet on the subdivisions you divide by the actual for the road, more roads for driving, no less than one.
Okay. All right.
Thank
you.
Mike.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Thank y'all for coming tonight.
Thank you for having us. Good.
Oh, one other comment I'd like to make.
Yes, sir.
I'm proud of something that we've been able to accomplish, and that is Cook Road. We have moved Cook Road up construction by 3 years. And the way we did it is we used Garvey bonds. Garvey bonds are bonds that you borrow against future income from the federal government. When we did the numbers on it, we found with the cost of construction going up so dramatically, we could actually borrow the money and pay it off cheaper than if we waited until 2013 to do the construction. So now we're set for right away this year and construction in 2010.
Does that include the bridge, Mr. Gannon?
Yes, sir.
Right.
Yes, sir. Maybe the tallest structure in Alamance County.
Yeah.
But that's the link from Westbrook to Highway 100.
That's right.
That link for Cook Road.
Yeah, University Drive to Cook Road link.
I think it'll be a great asset for the university.
Yes.
So
that's great news.
Thank you.
Is that a question?
Sure.
Thanks. Question for DOT. What is the process that you go through to permit commercial driveways?
They have to submit a detailed plan to Chuck Edwards, our district engineer. For Chuck is to permit, it has to show what's actually going on the site. It can't be a shell building, it can't be anything. It's got to be actually showing what's going on there with parking. Sometimes if it's a large enough facility, Chuck will require what's called a traffic impact analysis report. It will show you how much traffic is going to be generated there. And with that information, Chuck may require turn lanes and all that. It has to be a detailed plan.
Right now we have a situation here in the county. I have the phone calls and the emails of a commercial driveway right next to a home in somewhat of a residential section. And my understanding is there now is nothing that can be done about it.
We don't get involved in the zoning or anything. When they come to Chuck with a plan, you know, with where we're going in, we don't go and check the zoning or anything like that. We assume that it's met all the criteria for that. But Chuck will take that into, you know, all that plan and all that traffic generated by that development and the traffic on the existing road comes into play. And that's because of the part of Chuck's analysis of what he's going to require for that developer to do.
I will say that Jason Martin and I have been working together on the issue, maybe the one you're talking about, and we're going to take a look at that, you know, from our perspective and make sure that driveway is properly permitted.
And even if it is, there's still nothing that can be done as far as the residents are concerned?
That's more of a zoning issue that we rely on local government to handle.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, gentlemen. Good late. Appreciate y'all being here. Okay, next up is finance matters. We have two budget amendments tonight. The first one, budget 179, safety program. Ryan?
Good evening, Commissioners. I'm here to recommend that the board approves a transfer of $6,500 from the county's insurance fund to be used to offset costs of installation of security cameras at Cedar Rock Park. And I'd be happy to try to answer any questions that you may have about the project or anything else.
Any questions? Is there a motion?
Maybe.
Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
Thank you.
Next is three budget amendments, 188, 189, and 190 for the Social Services. Susan? Oh,
okay. Good evening. The 188 is an additional $46,200 to our DSS budget to, we received a grant to work on quality improvements in family care homes with medication administration. 189 and 190 are just to clean up our budgetary items for the year. We received cuts in allocation of $12,000 and $13,000 in our share of the warmth. We just didn't receive that much in donations. And then our FEMA project just went to a nonprofit. So we're just eliminating that out of our budget and cleaning up our lines for the end of the fiscal year.
Okay. Any questions on any one of those three? Do we have a motion to accept?
Motion.
Second. Any further discussion? Not all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carries.
Thank you.
Thank you, Susan. Zooming right on through the agenda. Mr. Manager?
Yes, sir. Commissioners, the first item is we sent out our bids for our property and liability insurance, and in your package you have the return on those bids. The Association of County Commissioners did $563,725, Wells Fargo $475. $475,803, and Summers Pardew, local bid was $470,968. Well, $470,968, yeah. And Summers Pardew being the lowest, and the fact that we have worked with Summers Pardew in the past, and I have found working with them to be so much more convenient and I would say the association has been the association with Summers Pardew was a lot more county friendly than the others that we have had, and I'm recommending that the low bid with Summers Pardew be accepted by the county. I think it's pretty well explained. You know, the ratings and all are in the memo, and I think considering everything, Summers Pardew, even though they are low bid, they come out on top in the other matters also.
David, do you recall what we're paying now, what our current premium?
I mean, what is it? Came down about what, 80 or 90?
$615,000.
From 615 to 470. 471. That's great. Okay, do we have a motion to accept the Summers Party bid for property and liability insurance?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Second, any further discussion? Not all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carries.
Yes, sir. I have a couple of matters. Brian, if you would bring the commissioners up to date on the Pleasant Grove Gym fire.
I was getting ready to ask you that. I didn't mean to let you get off the main stage for a while.
That's all right. That's all right. As I'm sure the board knows, we did have a fire out at Pleasant Grove Recreation Center this past Monday, June the 9th. That blaze, fire marshals investigated, originated in a supply closet. Fire department did an outstanding job containing the blaze on a few spaces. The building, though, has suffered a tremendous amount of smoke damage. The Pleasant Grove Rec Center will be closed to the public until further notice. However, the facility grounds, which include the baseball fields, the walking track, playground equipment, those remain open. The building itself is closed. We're very pleased that today the summer camp that we had scheduled for kids to begin today did begin on schedule. Alamance-Burnham school system has allowed us to access Pleasant Grove Elementary School. And so we was able to stay in this community, all 24 kids on site as planned, didn't miss a beat. We're very, very glad about that. And we'd also like to let the board know that the senior citizen programs, including things like bingos and potluck lunches, have been relocated to the Lakeview Civitan Club over on Roberta Drive, which is very nice of Lakeview to contact us and offer that. We were very, very glad that we could get the programs. That was the number one priority, to get them relocated. We also have been able to find staff for the five full-time employees. Worked very closely with Susan Osborne and HSC. We sure appreciate her help, too. And I wanted to just take a moment of your time to recognize Mr. Larry Evans. Larry, I'd ask you to stand up if you would, please. Larry is a part-time employee with our department, and Larry's also a volunteer fireman at Pleasant Grove Fire Department. And Larry was the gentleman that discovered the blaze at Pleasant Grove. He wasn't working. He was over at the fire department attending some training. And when he left, he's always very thorough, and he keeps an eye on our building and heard the audible alarm, saw the smoke, and the chief assured me that his actions saved the building. There's no question about it. So I asked Larry to be here tonight. Tell him we certainly appreciate it, and I'm sure the board does.
We do appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Appreciate it so
much.
Thank you.
So is there any questions? I can answer any questions about the center or fire or anything?
How about the granddad of Dance Land?
Big Daddy's Dance? That was the one program that we were not able to find space for. It is so unique to the Pleasant Grove Rec Center. He has a dance up there every Friday night, country, western, family friendly. Fortunately, that portion of the building was not damaged by the fire. It suffered some smoke damage. We hope that it will be one of the first places to get cleaned up. So he's bearing with us. He's very eager. He was on scene with me till about 2 a.m., really worried about what was going to happen. So he's definitely invested. He's been there about 4 years now. So, and that's a good program. Brings a lot of people up there.
Thank you, Brian.
All right. Thank you.
Brian also has another matter, Mr. Chairman, concerning the Glen Raven Park lease.
Yes, sir. We, as you know, last meeting we presented a proposed lease to the Board of Commissioners for acreage right up off of Highway 87 North to be used as a new canoe access point to the Hall River. The board did approve that action and the lease that we had at the time. We took that signed copy and that information over to Glen Raven and met with them. And they had some suggestions about the attachment in the lease that showed the actual property that would become under the authority of the department. We refined that a little bit. The property's gone from about 5.8 acres as named in the lease and delineated to 2.8 acres, which is in fact much more specific, and all we need to do is we need to do it here anyway. But it does require, I talked about before you this evening, and ask if you would vote to approve this amended lease. And if so, we'll be getting started on a new access point.
Have a motion.
Okay. I'll make the motion.
Second. Okay. For discussion? Not all in favor? Say
aye.
Aye. All opposed?
Thank you very much.
Commissioners, I have one other matter. Mac Williams sent me a memorandum a week or so ago concerning the possibility of an economic development project that he has been working on, and the business involved will be seeking incentives, and I'd like to ask the board to set a public hearing for this project July 7th, and send a memorandum. as soon as we send out the 10-day notice, I think most of the information that you want will be in that. And the company will be here on the 7th to present their proposal, if you accept it.
Okay. We have a motion to set a public hearing for July the 7th on an incentive request.
Second.
Any further discussion? Not all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, motion carries.
That's all I have, Mr. Chairman.
Consent agenda. If there's no objection, I'll make a motion that we accept the consent agenda in its entirety, items A through F. We have a second?
Second.
Any further discussion? Not all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, motion carries. Any commissioner have any announcements?
No, I do have a request. On these applications for different commissions that people want to be on, I would appreciate if they were a little more thorough or they were reviewed. I have a question about the mailing address, the home address, how long you've lived in Alamance County. Sometimes some of these things don't add up. And I think it would be nice if there was a place at the bottom where they would sign that, put that signature on there that the above information is complete and correct.
Okay.
Just like you do an application when you apply for a job or any other application.
Ed, how do you gather the information for the application? You talk to the applicant?
It just depends. A lot of times they're just subpoenaed.
I will say that we have an awful hard time getting people to serve, and the more information that's going to be required is certainly not going to help us fill all of these positions. We've got openings coming out of our ears now. People just don't want to have their names spread. They don't want to be in the public eye, but they will serve. I'm a little leery that if we keep asking them for more and more information, we'll have less and less people apply.
You know, it's like this one. The home address is Chapel Hill, but they say the number of years in Alamance County as a resident is 10 years. You know, I'm not getting the connection here, and that's what I was questioning.
I don't know about that particular one. We'll find out for you.
Well, this is just an example. I've noticed it in the past, and I thought I would.
Years they lived here does not go for that most recent application. It's from the first time they were ever appointed to a board. So I have their original information. I just continue that.
And then there
might not match up with the date that's on it.
Jerry Cone, you know him, see?
I do know Jerry. He he's currently serving on our Recreation Advisory Commission and volunteered to be replaced. I mean to be reappointed. And we've used in the past the same standard we use for service provision for appointees. If you own property in Alamance County, our department says you're eligible to take part in the services that we offer. And Mr. Cone's been a long-time resident here. He did relocate to Chapel Hill, but he still owns property here in the county. So we were actually trying to use the same standard as far as service provision. We have, right now, our policy in our department is if you own property in Alamance County or paying county property taxes, you're eligible to take part in the programs that the department offers. So we were looking at the same standard. Mr. Cone, we found him to be, just I'll speak on his personal application, he's been extremely helpful in our department. He's with American Farmland Trust. He's very knowledgeable of conservation efforts and has actually been working with us on some projects down around Cedar Run. So I certainly understand the commissioner's concern.
Yeah, no, I'm not picking on him.
Right.
Could we just add on here that a statement that the above information is accurate and complete and have them sign it, and then all you can do when you enter it is say signed. You don't have to have a signature, but you know, just the fact that it was signed and we'd understand what that was.
Well, a lot of times they don't fill out an application. We might do, when we do reappointment, just ask if they want to serve again, so they don't even sign another application. It's not
at all. Well, that their application is in fact correct, or you know, that previous application is correct.
First time.
Yeah. Sorry.
But it wouldn't be every. I mean, we don't get them to fill out an application every time they're reappointed.
Well, that I understand.
So it wouldn't be in the packet. So you still wouldn't see that. It's, you just want a statement at the bottom.
Yeah, that you know, that application is complete and correct.
Okay, any other questions or announcements?
I'd like to ask a question. I know I did vote to support the public hearing for the industrial discussion. But are they expecting a vote that night on the Senate?
Yes.
Sight unseen.
No, they'll present their problem.
I mean, without any research. I mean,
No. We have to give notice 10 days before that meeting in the newspaper. And that will have more details in it. The company, that sort of thing, how much they're going to invest, how many jobs.
Before the public hearing?
Yes.
Okay. So I certainly don't want to have to
right.
be here with it and have to make a decision. Snap decision. Well, it should be done that way.
Right. Any other announcements? If not, thank you for coming. Meeting adjourned.
Thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Typically, the first meeting of the month is held at 9 a.m. and the second meeting is held at 7 p.m. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioner's website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the Commissioners on the second and fourth Friday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel beginning at 3 p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching Commissioner meetings online. For technical questions about this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of Commissioner meetings may be made to the Commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says County Commissioners to visit the Commissioners' website, where you can learn about our Commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting.